All right, it's official. Broncos head coach Vic Fangio is head coach no longer. The Broncos will now begin their search for their 18th head coach in franchise history. We'll start with Bruce and Taylor, the entire sports team here, breaking it down. Bruce, I guess obviously this move needed to be made in your eyes, in Broncos country's eyes, and most importantly, in GM George Payton's eyes.
Yeah, I think there was a certain sense of fait accompli last night. This was inevitable. I thought it was ironic that Vic's 3 years end in the last 4 minutes with a very controversial call to go for a field goal, right? To get to within 4 points when all of us were shaking our heads. Look, I wish him nothing but the best. I think all of us were around him enough to know that he was extremely – he was a likable guy. He worked extremely hard at his job. I think we can all agree – that he is a fine defensive coach. And I think that we can all agree that he probably wasn't a very good head coach. And I think that ultimately that's probably what led George Payton and Joe Ellis to this point. The fact that you're 19 and 30 over 3 years, you haven't broached the playoffs. You were 7-6 this year, but you ended up finishing 4-10 after a 3-0 start. There were just too many statistical signposts, Nick, to think that this wasn't a reasonable outcome. And, of course, it's happened this morning.
Yeah, and we've seen those shows upwards of, you know, 10,000 to 15,000 the previous, what, two, 3 weeks out in the Power Field at Mile High. So the brand of football, Taylor, I mean, not only are the wins and losses not there, but it's not exactly the most exciting brand of football when you're talking about trying to put some points on the scoreboard to win some football games. Do we expect the Broncos, do you think, Taylor, to look for, I don't know, an offensive-minded head coach?
I don't know. It's hard to tell at this point because they have had so much success. And then you look at that defensive personnel and they're stacked. So you want someone to come in here who's able to gel, who's able to have a similar mind as them. But because of their offensive issues, I mean, we heard it last night in Vic Fangio's post-game press conference. Why aren't you guys at the top of the AFC West? Quarterback situation. He kind of threw Lock and Teddy Bridgewater under the bus, which doesn't come as a surprise to us as to how they're thinking. But the plan was to have Teddy Bridgewater come in here this year and be that veteran presence. We didn't know what we were going to get. Did we get a good Teddy Bridgewater? Yes, but we have to have a great quarterback. You see Justin Herbert, you see Patrick Mahomes, you see Derek Carr and what he's doing. I mean, the Chargers and Raiders are playing for a playoff spot tonight. The Broncos should be in that situation. And so when it comes to searching for a new head coach, there's got to be some offensive flow because he set the foundation. We've heard that word foundation a lot from this team in the last couple of days. They've set the foundation defensively, I think, and as a team and what their mindset is. But offensively, something has to give.
Final question back to you, Bruce. I'll pick up what Taylor just said. We do hear that the foundation is there. The key pieces are there, especially in the defensive side of the football. Yet this is a franchise that's looking to make major overhauls from the top down, from ownership, possibly John Elway and his exec role as his contract comes to an end. The head coach, now that's a move that's already been made. And obviously, as Taylor just pointed out, there's going to be change to the quarterback position as well. Can we buy into the fact that this team really is close to getting back to the playoffs?
Well, I guess it depends on what your definition of close is. This is a 7-10 football team that played a last place schedule. Yeah. Look, this is the NFL. You can blow sunshine or spin things any way that you wish, but it all gets back to what your record says that you are. I mean, Bill Parcells was right all of those years ago. This is a 7-10 football team. Okay, third best scoring defense in the NFL. Great. What does that get you? 7-10. Outside looking in. Only the Jets have missed the playoffs now for more consecutive seasons than the Denver Broncos. Nick, we're getting into generational things here. This is six straight years. You and I remember the Broncos at their peak, but there we are getting to a point now where there are fans growing up now that are thinking, well, the Broncos just aren't very good. Yeah. That's a real problem at this point. But to your point, and it's a good one, the difficulty of this decision is going to be The fact that there are so many moving parts that create questions. George Payton is the guy navigating it. I think the three of us, the four of us, with Dave Althaus as our executive sports producer behind the scenes, feel that George Payton is the right guy. I hope so, because by all appearances, he's the guy that's going to make this decision. Taylor's right. There has to be an offensive component to this decision. We'll just have to wait and see. But to your point, they're going to change their ownership here this spring. So we're going to bring in an entirely new staff before ownership has a chance to take a look at it. Now, look, most good owners will take a year to look at things, but that still is a very tight space to make changes effectively.
A lot of moving parts, faith in George Payton. I have concerns about losing a defensive mind such as Vic Fangio. This is a top three scoring defense this year. Of course, there's that whole other component of, you know, scoring points to win games thing. So hopefully they'll get the guy that can get in there and get this thing moving in the right direction. Good analysis as always, guys. Appreciate you joining from home. And, of course, the rest of Broncos country, we'll be breaking this down on air. KWGN as well as KDVR, as well as our websites, KDVR.com, KWGN.com. Who sort of joins for the Sunday Sports Zone. That should be a good one on Fox 31 tonight at 10:30. All right, for Bruce and Taylor and Nick, we'll see you later. Thanks for watching.